Let's do some more on the cost of living crisis, because it's something where I reckon the government is doing four-fifths of bugger all, but is pretending to be active and also trying to shift the blame. For instance, Labor's policies are pushing inflation up. It's labour market re-regulation caving into the unions. That's pushed up business costs. It's energy policies and the reckless rush to renewables continues to push up electricity prices, which, of course, adds to the cost of everything and puts pressure on households as well. And then there's Labor's record government spending and record immigration. But the Albanese government isn't really doing anything to tackle these fundamentals, the things it can control. Instead, it's trying to shift the blame elsewhere. There's the supermarkets, of course, with a focus on competition regulation.
We're providing $30 million of additional funding for the watchdog to make sure that they, the ACCC, can clamp down on supermarkets and make sure that consumers are getting a fair deal. When there's cost of living pressures...
Yeah, it's the evil supermarkets, apparently, even though their profit margins are about 3%. And Labor's also trying to blame the banks by focusing on service charges.
It's also about easing the cost of living. And the measures that the Treasurer spoke about before in outlawing debit card surcharges...
Yeah, fiddling around the edges. And as I showed you earlier, Albanese's even been into social media stunts and product shrinkage.
You will have seen it. A product comes out in new packaging. It's the same price as before, but the box feels a little bit lighter. It's called shrinkflation.
Shrinkflation, it sounds like something from George Costanza, doesn't it? We're facing a real cost of living crisis, and the Albanese government is preoccupied with this blame shifting and these gimmicks instead of pulling the right economic levers that it can actually control.